gentlemen, before you get seated, please do me a favor. Right now, if you are one of our guests, please find your student who is graduating today, and I want to hear from you.
All right.
Approximately 1,100 graduating students. As we celebrate this special occasion, I want to extend collective gratitude to our elected officials, to our community partners, to the donors who support our students through scholarships, to our Foundation Board of Trustees, and to our Alumni Association Board. Their tireless support has a positive impact on our students, and we thank them all. It is my additional honor to bring greetings from the Board of Regents of the University System of Georgia. I also want to take this opportunity to recognize the many guests who have chosen to celebrate with us via live stream. So pardon me, I'm waving at those folks. We feel your presence here with us today, and we hope that you in turn can feel the energy and excitement of these graduating students. I also want to acknowledge our marshal for today, Mark Pergram. So if you could give him a hand, he is this morning's marshal. Mark, stay with us. As president, it is always an honor to preside over this very special event. It is the greatest gift while serving as the president of the college. I think I can speak for everyone at GHC when I say nothing brings the faculty and staff more joy than the day we see our students rise as graduates, the day we celebrate each of you students for all that you have accomplished here at Georgia Highlands College. At this moment, you are making history for yourself, for your family, for the family and friends who will follow you. Today, you will leave us as a college graduate. That is no small accomplishment. It will remain your moment and part of your history forever. And, probably most importantly, it equips you so that you may influence others in the future. You also join a class of graduates making history today. This commencement marks a return to an on-campus commencement, a tradition dating back to the founding of our college. 50 years ago, a single graduate attended the first commencement ceremony in 1971 on this campus in the president's office. And every generation of graduates since that one student has joined a history that will never be forgotten. Earlier this year, we lost one of our founding faculty members, Dr. James Cook, a historian who wrote extensively about the governors of Georgia and about Georgia Highlands College. I'd like to summarize a brief portion of his book concerning the importance of GHC's history. The fact that this history of GHC has been published shows its metamorphosis will continue, and that those who come after us will be guided by a clear sense of mission, passion, and unity, values that built this institution and values that position the college to continue to serve as a point of access for higher education. With this class of 2021 being my last commencement at GHC as president, I would be remiss if I did not thank our faculty and staff for their continued love for our students and your support for our college. Folks, I am forever in your debt. And now I want to underscore the sentiment in Dr. Cook's statement concerning GHC's clear sense of mission, passion, and unity by welcoming to the stage the person who will serve as GHC's interim president and continue guiding GHC into the future, Dr. Dana Nichols.
By honoring these students with us today who, as you mentioned, are the ones making history as the 51st graduating class at Georgia Highlands College. For this reason and many more, it will be our honor and privilege to bestow on you these diplomas today. Now, I'd like to introduce our platform guests. Please stand when your name is called. Mr. Jamie Petty, Vice President of Finance and Administration. Ms. Trevise Obus, Professor of Communication, who will announce our graduates, our candidates for graduation. Thank you so much for joining us today in this celebration. I would also like to take time to recognize traditional platform members, Mr. Donnie Denson, President of GHC Alumni Association, and Mr. Matthew Perry, President of GHC's Student Government Association, for their important work. Donnie and Matthew typically would be on stage and speak with you today, but they have graciously acknowledged the need for social distancing on stage and a briefer commencement ceremony. Graduates, please find messages from these gentlemen in your program. As a matter of fact, some of you may have met your SGA president along your processional this morning as he served as a line marshal. Matthew, will you please stand for recognition? Next, I have the very real privilege of announcing the recipient of the Wesley C. Wellraven Faculty Award for 2021. Today, I am thrilled to announce that Professor Billy Morris has been selected for the second consecutive year. For those who may not know, the Wellraven Award is named in memory of Dr. Wesley Wellraven, the academic dean at Floyd Junior College, now GHC, from its founding in 1970 until 1993. Dr. Wellraven was noted for many positive characteristics, but especially his keen intelligence, his unselfish dedication to students, and his quiet focus. Professor Morris exemplifies these traits. He is an outstanding choice for this prestigious award. Having earned a BS from Georgia Southern in 1980 and an MS from Emory in 1986, Billy has served at GHC since June 1994. There are too many accolades and accomplishments to mention here, but among Billy's many noteworthy endeavors is his highly successful Wyoming Study Away program, which takes geology students out into the field to learn. Billy was also voted by his colleagues to serve as Mace Bearer this year. Please join me in congratulating Professor Billy Morris for these well-deserved honors.
Thank you, Dr. Nichols. Congratulations, graduates. You're here. It's your day. I would like to recognize the graduation committee led by Tammy Nichols and Sheila Jones. What a wonderful job they've done on the plans for today, along with the people who helped them. How about a round of applause? Graduates, surrounding you are people who have given you their unfailing support. They had to come here by invitation only, so I know that they're special to you. But I know they're not the only ones. You have children, you have parents, grandparents, significant others. You have a whole group of people who have supported you when you needed them to bring you here to this day. And so I'd like to acknowledge those people as well. Keep them in your hearts and in your minds, whether they're here or not this morning. Some years ago, when I was a younger faculty member at Floyd College, in my first commencement ceremonies, I decided that the Walraven Award was given to a faculty member who was about to retire. So I've come here with an important announcement for you today. I'm not going anywhere. My mom taught college for 40 plus years, and I learned from her the joy and satisfaction that comes from that profession. So I still have some things to do. Yeah. One of the things that I do every graduation day is carry this picture. You can't see it from where you are, but it's a picture of my dad's graduation. Me as a four-year-old standing close to him down at the First Baptist Church in Rome, Georgia. I didn't really know what was going on, but he set an example for me that day. Just as about 51 years ago, a group of staff and faculty and administrators had a vision and set an example for what this institution could be. And we've far exceeded their dreams, I'm sure, if they could only be here today and see what we're doing. And some of them still are. The example that was set for me was that a small group of dedicated people, even one person, with a vision and a dream, can achieve that. They established this college. You have now become a part of it. I watched this happen because my dad was an original employee of Floyd Junior College, and I got to see it unfold before my very eyes. Graduates, what I want you to remember, and this is incredibly powerful and important, is that today you're setting an example for someone too. Somebody is looking at you saying, I can do that. And that will be true for the rest of your life. So if you take nothing else away from today, please remember that throughout your life. Very important. Faculty, we've all learned that our students come and they go. That's what they do. We train them up and we send them on to greater success. And we have also learned that administrators come and they go. And we do the same thing. We train them up and we send them on to greater success. And we wish you the best, Dr. Green, as you move ahead. So who is left? Who's left? We are. We are left. Those who have determined to make GHC a part of their history, those who have planted seeds and established roots, whether you're from Northwest Georgia or not. Now the next few years might be tough. We've seen tough years come and go. But we do have the opportunity, and we should see this as an opportunity, to set the future course for Georgia Highlands College, just as our founders did. If you're satisfied with it, then share that satisfaction. If you're not satisfied with it, then be the change that you want to see in the institution, and then share that. For we own this institution, and we have the privilege and responsibility, and yes, even the joy, to create the future of Georgia Highlands College. And as Dean Walraven said, we will just keep doing the right things for our students until somebody tells us to stop. I haven't been told to stop yet. Have you? I learned a few other lessons from my dad. He taught me how to sail. The college used to have sailboats right down in Paris Lake behind this building here. And I learned about a very important sailing term. It's called a knockdown. A knockdown is when a wind comes out of nowhere and flips you sideways. And you find yourself in the water, cold, wet, all your things are bobbing about you, complete chaos. We've been through a knockdown in the last year. But with strong leadership, we pulled ourselves up out of the water. We've gathered our things back into the boat. We've righted it, and we're back on course. And I'm so very proud of all of you, faculty, colleagues, students, family support. I have so much confidence that you're going to achieve great success going forward, and how could you not? You might not have everything that you had a year ago, but you do have everything that you need. Thank you.
Privileges, and responsibilities.
Recipients, you are welcome to remove your mask as you cross the stage to receive your diplomas. Will the recipients of a bachelor's degree please come forward to receive your diplomas?
Graduates, as you come up, many of you know over the years that if I know you well, I tend to be a hugger. We're not going to be able to do that today. And I'm sure you understand why. So I'm going to be handing you your diploma and doing a fist bump. And if out of habit I should try to give you a hug, just push me away.
Guillermo Aguilar, summa cum laude. Yasmin Aguilar. Nora Germaine Berry. Nancy Wanyechi Tiri. Heather R. Choate, cum laude. Kimberly Lynn Postel. No! Tiffany A. Stewart. Megan Lynn Shelton, magna cum laude. Carrie Elizabeth Sayer, magna cum laude. Victoria Leanne Stafford. Georgia Claire Steele. Keeper Elijah Stroop. Kaylin Lee Tomlin. Barrett. Savannah Josephine Brunette. Christopher Timothy Collins, cum laude. Madison T. Clines. Neely Sarah Collum, summa cum laude. Emily McAllister Cox. Haley F. Chronic. Andrew T. Lumpkin, summa cum laude. Anna McTeer, magna cum laude.
Takaya
Will all the graduates please stand? Give them a hand, folks. Commencement volunteers to quickly prepare our venue for the next ceremony group. I now ask everyone to please stand and remain standing for the recessional after Professor Robert Adams leads us for the GHC alumni.